and punish those who do evil. So now you have the free will. It's like operation. You have operation, bro. Anyway, what I was going to say, so those who do rash actions will be rewarded. Those who does evil will be punished. Now you have the life and you have the free will to choose what you should do. Instead, you know, we should serve the Creator, we should worship Him. Let me tell you something, yeah, before I let you go, because I don't want to make you... If I give you £2 million as a gift, I say, you know what, I'm a billionaire. Are you like you? I have too much money. I just want to give it away. I'm going to give you £2 million as a gift. What would you say to me, at least? £2 million. Would you remember me all the time?
Yes.
It's coming now. It's coming. So you will remember me and you will thank me. I will give you £2 million on a condition, give me your two eyes. No, why? Because your eyes is more valuable than anything, than any money. So why we are not grateful and thankful to the one that gave us eyes for free? You see, that's what Islam teaches you. Be grateful to your Creator. Serve Him. Now let me give you another question. If you want to buy a gift for your mother, are you going to buy a gift that you love or your mother love? Likewise, we should worship the way the Creator love, not the way we love. The way He loves is objective. The way He loves is subjective. That's why He sent prophets and messengers to teach us about our purpose in this life. When you die or she dies, everyone, we're not going to take nothing with us except our righteous actions. And the biggest crime is to worship someone beside Allah or turn away from the teaching of Allah. We love Jesus, but His teaching has been corrupted without any doubt. It's been changed. The true teaching of Jesus and Moses is in the Quran. What do you think what I said so far? Does it make sense? That's why it's Islam. You're more close to Islam. I invite you to become Muslim. Why don't you become Muslim? Why?
Still choosing.
Huh?
Choosing.
Yeah, like what questions do you have? Assalamu alaikum. Ask any question, as long as you don't ask me what is my age. Okay. Yeah, no problem. Let me give you something to read, please. Okay, brother. Are you Muslim as well? What do you mean spiritual?
I believe God is energy.
Wait. You believe God is energy. But what is energy? Define it.
Energy is anything.
That's it. Physics say, energy doesn't exist by itself. Energy has to be embodied in something else. You have energy in you, you know. So the point here is that when you say, I believe in energy, that is, that in a reality, doesn't make any sense, because you're saying, which energy you're referring to? Because energy is not an entity by itself you can point at.
I believe God.
No, what we say, and tell me what you think what I'm going to say, yeah? I believe God, yes, He has, we don't use the word energy, yeah? We use the word God has a power, okay? But that is not sufficient for God to create, because I can bring to you someone has a power, but he doesn't have if he doesn't have a knowledge how to make a phone, would he be able to make a phone? No. So you need the power and you need what? Knowledge. Okay? So these two attributes doesn't exist by itself. It has to be embodied or in someone. Okay? Now he has a power, he has a knowledge, but he doesn't have a free will. Would he be able to make a phone? So he needs a free will. So that's what is the Creator. The Creator, he has a power, he has a knowledge, he has a will, he has a mercy, he has a wisdom. But what people say is energy, as I said, energy is a term we don't use, because the Creator never said he has energy. He said he has a power, he has ability, he has a will. Understand? So you believe there is a Creator that created the creation. Okay? Speak to you soon, inshallah. Yeah? Take care. Yeah, sorry, sister. Go on. Again, conscious, what do you mean by that? Yeah, consciousness is something which is like when you have consciousness, when you have something to, like a faculty. It's a faculty that you utilize to realize something. Consciousness, yes? Okay. But again, that is not God. Because what you have to understand, God is not like the creation, firstly. Secondly, what is logical and rational, that God created the creation, yes. However, God is not like the creation at all. Just like the carpenter is not like the door. The door and the carpenter is not the same. Not because the carpenter made the door, therefore they must share the same thing. You understand? So my point here is, when you look at Islamic way of explaining the Creator, we say, he's a perfect being, and he has a wisdom, and he has a mercy, and he has a justice, and he has ability, and based upon that, he created creation, and we can analyze his creation, and we can see his wisdom, we can see his mercy, and we can see his anger, we can see his power, all of that. However, now the question we ask ourselves, how can we know we are serving the Creator the way he wants us to serve him? How can we know that?
I don't believe in living for God.
You don't know what?
I don't believe in serving like a higher power. I believe that kind of sets us down.
I can't hear you though. Sorry. You can't hear.
I don't believe in serving like a higher power.
But that's contradiction, because why? Before the creation, what was God?
I mean, we're all a part of God.
We're not part of God.
No, like, nothing would exist without the mind believing that it's there.
No one would exist without?
The mind believing that it's there.
No, you know what you're talking about? You're talking about, you are coming from the argument and the philosophical that starts in the 18th century by a German philosopher who said the man is God. You know?
It's like Hinduism before it became a religion.
Yeah, but again, how do you know Hinduism is correct?
Because I'm spiritual myself, I have my
third eye
open, I can see energy, I can see it around me.
No, but
you.
You experience it, you cannot see energy, show me where is energy.
You can see energy around people, of course you can.
No, you cannot.
So how come psychics are real?
Huh?
How come psychics are real?
So what?
How come psychics are real? How come you hear
it? Psychics is real, I'm confused. If the scientists would tell you, you cannot see. And energy is not entity by itself. Energy is an attribute that exists in something else.
Yes.
You cannot point out at energy. Like here, there's we say karma has energy, but you cannot say energy such and such. Energy is not entity that exists by itself. It's an attribute. And before the creation, what I'm going to say to you, before the creation, there was a creator, correct? Okay, so the creator clearly is separate from his creation. So a logical way would say, either when the creator created the creation, he created it, then he entered into the creation, or he created the creation in himself, or he created the creation separate from him. Which one is the logical and rational way?
I don't think it's separate.
But we clearly see there's a difference between you and I. If all of us have God in us, you have different power than me. So we can see we're not one.
What I'm saying is, one consciousness doesn't mean we're all the same, we all think the same. It's just one consciousness, it's just we come from one thing. Like, you know how science says we came from dead stars, whatever, blah, blah, blah. So we all come from one universe.
Yeah, no, we agree with that. All of us, we've been created from one. For example, we believe everything was created from water. There's no doubt about that. But that doesn't resolve the issue that you have.